Hello, my name is Crystal Chibu and I'm your Hope Catalyst. Today I'm going to be sharing with you how to get volunteers. If you are yet to subscribe to this YouTube channel, please make sure that you subscribe. Just hit the button and make sure that you turn on the notification button also so that you don't forget to receive anything from us at all. Today again, like I said, I will be sharing how to get volunteers. But before we even talk about how we want to get volunteers, who is a volunteer? A volunteer is someone that gives their time or their service voluntarily to a community service to create impact, to make change happen, to make sure that the work that anyone in the nonprofit space is doing is made possible. So that's who a volunteer is. And sometimes you're not really thinking of nonprofit in terms of the nonprofit alone. You see volunteers even in the church, in the mosque, you know, but when you think of it, it's actually in a space where people don't have to pay for the service. So yes, that's who a volunteer is. And so if you are in the nonprofit space, you definitely need the support of volunteers from time to time. One of the very good things that volunteers do for us is they help us cut costs. Because if you were to pay for that service or pay for that headcount as it is, you know that you're going to be spending a lot. So what happens is when you have volunteers that are available to make this service available for you, it then reduces your cost. And I'm sure that we all love to reduce costs, especially for those of us in that, you know, in the nonprofit space. Because what it does for us is somehow you still get that same quality of service from the person, but now you're not paying for it at all. So to get volunteers, there are a few things that need to be in place. And the first thing that I'm going to be talking about is actually having a defined vision. You might say, Crystal, what has vision got to do with volunteers? Because one of the things that happen is when people buy into your vision, when people understand what it is that you want to do and it keys into what they want for their lives, then there is alignment of purpose. And because there's that alignment, it's easier for the person to be a part of what you want to do. And so that's why you need to have that clearly defined vision. In my own case, what basically happened was we had a very clearly defined vision for the Iradia Foundation. And so a lot of people find themselves in that vision, wanting to support children with disabilities and making sure that they give artificial limbs to children that cannot afford it. And so for some people, because they probably don't have the cash to give to the foundation, they have skills in accounting, they have skills in data management, they decide to come and spend some time with us to make this available for us. So we don't have to pay for that service. And however, they are actually giving limbs because of what they're doing. So you need to have a clearly defined vision that people can align with. The second thing that you have to do is you now need to communicate that vision. Because when you have a clearly defined vision that only you know about, then I don't know that I fit into what you're doing and then come and give my service to you. So that's why it's important for you, after you have defined the vision, to communicate that vision to as many people as possible. Sometimes you even get volunteers from other people recommending because they know what it is that you've communicated that you want, and they know someone else that wants to provide that service, and they're able to bring it together. So it's important for you to let people know, communicate it, put it out on social media. You are on social media, word of mouth, tell your friends about it. Oh, this is what we do at the foundation. We work with children that have been amputated so that they and their family members can live independent lives. However, in order to be able to make this vision happen, we need an accountant, and currently we cannot pay for an accountant. So when you put it out there, what happens is people start to find a point of alignment Once you have this spoken about and you have other people also that can talk about it. So yes, I said you can put it on social media, but not just social media alone. Word of mouth also works. And then if you have a website, you can also put it out there on your website for people to know that you seek volunteers, and they find that it's in line with what they want to do. And boom, they actually just do that. That's the second thing. The third thing, when you are trying to get volunteer, after you have actually defined what you want and after you have communicated it, is that you definitely start building relationships in that regard. There are a lot of organizations that, you know, all they do is pull together volunteers, and when they have a, you know, group of volunteers, you can attach yourself to that network and find a way to see how you can work through that network. So it's important also to start building those kind of relationships. So build relationship with other organizations that are providing that service of giving volunteers to other people. What I have said today is three major things that I think it's important when you're trying to get volunteers. The first one that I talked about is that you have a clearly defined goal or a clearly defined mission as an organization. The second thing that I talked about is communicating that mission. The third thing is, I said, build relationships, build networks that have organized, that are putting volunteers together. Having done all of these things, you begin to see people that align with your vision. Remember, especially for startup nonprofit, you need volunteers to help you to reduce your costs. You need people to be able to give you services. So it's not all the time that people are going to give you money to fund the work that you're doing. People can provide services for you for free, for you to be able to do the good that you want to do in the community. And I hope that this has helped you today. If this video has helped you to achieve getting a volunteer, what I want you to do is share with other people. And don't forget also to subscribe and also click the notification button. Thank you.